The visionary package of Merchant Navy Decoded till June 2021 covers pressure gauge, valves, workshop technology, filter cleaning, manometer, and pumps. By September 2021, Merchant Navy Decoded will try to cover reefer system, AC system, compressed air system, Saturday rounds, incinerator, oily water separator, fresh water generator, purifier, steering gear, CO2 room, chemicals, hypermes system, some main engine related videos, some generator related videos, loops, emergency stops, quick closing valves, fire alarms, alarm monitoring system, blower funnel flaps, unmanned machinery system, emergency generator, hot spots, stores and spares, and a few other videos. Now let us watch a video on pumps from the pump series in the visionary package. In this video, we will learn about group starter panels, various pump fitted in engine room. We will also learn in detail about their uses, types and capacities while taking engine room round.
Jai Mata Di, today I'm going to talk about pumps. When I talk about pumps, I'm going to give you a brief description. I'm going to take you through an engine room round where I'm going to show you all the pumps, their location, what kind of pumps they are and what's the use. But mostly all the pumps which are located in engine room, we have got these, their group starter panels inside engine control room. Now see guys, the biggest is the ballast pump over here. This is a huge breaker over here. You see the, you can make out from the size of the breaker over here. This is a normal fan, normal pump, small breakers. Ballast pump has got a huge breaker over here. Why? Because this is a 160 kilowatt motor and 1200 meter cubes per hour pump. That's the ballast pump. Amperage is normally 220 to 230 amps. Apart from that, we have got a main engine cylinder oil transfer. That's a gear pump, guys. We have got HFO transfer pump. That's a gear pump. We have got main engine lube oil pump. Now, iska thoda breaker you can see is a bit bigger. It's a 90 kilowatt motor. It's a centrifugal pump for supplying cylinder lube oil for bearings of main engine lubrication and all those things. We have got seawater pump. Lube oil pump, we have got two in numbers. One group, guys, this is group 2. Okay, guys, this is number 2 group starter panel. And you wait over there only. And this is the number 1 group starter panel. So all those pumps which we have got 2 or 3, so one set is going to be present over there and one set is going to be present over here. See, so what happens is, on that group starter panel, I have got main, this is number 1 main engine jacket cooling water pump. Now this is a centrifugal pump. So I have got number 2 main engine jacket cooling fresh water pump over here. You can see, I have got number 1 LT pump, LT fresh water pump, and number 3 LT fresh water pump over here. So I will definitely have number 2 LT fresh water pump over here, which you can see. Now this LT fresh water pump is of 70 kilowatt motor, as well as 75 kilowatt motor, guys. Now on board ship, I have got 3 main seawater pumps. Number 1 main seawater pump is located over here, and number 2 main seawater pump, number 2 main seawater pump, and number 3 main seawater pump is located over here. This is their ammeters. I have explained before in one of my videos, again I am telling you guys, see over here, this standby light is on. What does that mean? If the number 1 main seawater, see, number 2 seawater pump is running right now. The start run light is green. It is running, amperage is approximately 48-49. So this is standby. What does that mean? In case if this pump trips or pressure reduces, automatically this pump is going to start and the alarm is going to come in engine room. That is why it is on auto change. The moment I put it on manual, see, the standby light goes. The moment I put it on auto, the standby light comes. This is the button to press start. This is the button to press stop. This is a space heater. Motors, all the motors have got space heaters on board ship. Why? So that condensation does not take place, insulation does not get damaged. So these are all the group starter panels. Let's go and take a round. Jai Mata Di. Jai Mata Di, guys. My height is 5 feet 6 inches. I am standing on the discharge line of the ballast pump. You can see over here. and this is the ballast pump. That's the size. This is the huge size of the motor that I've got. And this is the huge ballast pump that I can see down below. Guys, it's a centrifugal pump. Ballast pump. All those pumps which have got huge capacities are normally centrifugal pumps. Okay, now let me come up. Red line over here. This is the fire line. In case we have fire on board ship, apart from emergency fire pump, these are the pumps that we have got on board ship. Just switch them on. Large capacity pumps, automatically water comes into the fire hydrant. We can extinguish the fire. Copy guys, these are specialized ballast pumps and fire and GS pumps have got a special pump attached to them. This is a vacuum pump fitted over here, guys. I am going to discuss this pump later theoretically. This is a vacuum pump fitted and very, very important part on board ship. Okay? Come guys. These are the main seawater pumps. We have got three main seawater pumps on board ship. Right now, number two main seawater pump is running. The suction pressure is 0.1 MPa, that is 1 bar, and discharge pressure is approximately 2.4 bar, guys. It's a 30 kilowatts motor approximately, a 30 kilowatt motor. Come. This is also a centrifugal pump. Fire and GS pump is also a centrifugal pump. Ballast pump is also a centrifugal pump. Now, let me show you a gear pump. I've got two gear pumps right now, HFO transfer pump and diesel oil transfer pump. We normally know that when transferring heavy oil or diesel oil or lube oil, we need positive displacement pumps. So they can be the gear pump or screw pumps. Jai Mata Di, come. This is the propeller shaft and these are the main engine lube oil pumps, and main engine sump is actually located beneath. So these are the lube oil pumps, 90 kilowatt capacity. Again, main engine lube oil pump is a centrifugal pump, because for main engine lubrication of bearings, cooling, we need large flow of oil at low pressure. These are stern tube lube oil pumps. Again, we have got two in numbers. These are gear pumps. This is the arithmetic gear is fitted, guys. Suction pressure gauge, discharge pressure gauge. Suction side, we have got a filter fitted as well. You can see out here. Okay. This is a lube oil transfer pump. Again, guys, this is also gear pump fitted over here. Suction pressure gauge, discharge pressure gauge, suction filter, vent cock for purging. Come. Capacity. It's a reciprocating pump. When this motor runs, this shaft has got a reciprocating system fitted over here, and pumping take place. Discuss karenge baad mein details, guys. The clean bilge water pump, again, the purpose is the same. It is used for pumping out clean water from the bilge settling tank into the bilge holding tank. This is a bilge separator tank, guys. It has got 5 meter cube capacity. It is a mono screw pump. See, at one point of time when you will have experience by your side, just by looking at the pump, you will be able to make out whether it's a gear pump, screw pump, centrifugal pump, what kind of pump it is. So when I look at this pump, when I see this body like this, I know it's a mono screw pump. What is this? This is a relief valve head. If the discharge and pressure increases, this relief valve will lift and the discharge oil or water, whatever it is, will come from here back into the suction side. Copy guys? Come. Jai Mata Di, this is a sludge pump fitted over here. All the junior engineers, those who are going to join onboard ship, this is the pump that you are going to love the most, along with the bilge pump. Why that bilge pump which I showed you over there? Because bilges transfer, junior engineer job. चलो भाई डेली बिल्जेस ट्रांसफर करने हैं वेयर इनटू द बिल्ज होल्डिंग टैंक. सिमिलरली स्लज फ्रॉम स्लज टैंक, फ्रॉम फ्यूल ऑयल प्यूरीफाई स्लज टैंक, ल्यूब ऑयल प्यूरीफाई स्लज टैंक, ऑयली बिल्ज टैंक, वॉट एवर द नेम ऑफ द टैंक इज. सो यू हैव टू ट्रांसफर बिल्जेस फ्रॉम वन टैंक टू अनदर और टू इंसिनरेटर बेस्ड ऑयल टैंक. फ्रॉम देयर यू हैव टू बर्न स्लज एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स. सो दिस इज अ स्लज पंप. नाउ अगेन व्हाट काइंड ऑफ पंप दिस इज? दिस इज अ मोनो स्क्रू पंप. इट हैज गॉट अ रिलीफ वाल्व फिटेड ऑन द डिस्चार्ज साइड. इफ द प्रेशर इज मोर, it automatically lift and the oil goes into the suction side. What is this given over here, guys? This is basically given for priming. In case sometimes your, though it's a positive displacement pump, and it still if it is not working properly, then in that case you provide them proper suction. So what it is, you add oil over here taki pump suction lele, and then you can start the suction from the tanks wherever you need. Now we are on the second platform. Okay, the main engine jacket water pump. It's again a centrifugal pump. When your main engine is stopped, this is the, this pump takes suction from the jacket water side and circulates it to the heater, so that jacket water temperature is maintained. These are main engine jacket water pumps. Again centrifugal pumps, suction pressure gauge, discharge pressure gauge. Hi, this is a local. If I want to start the pump, stop the pump from over, I can do that easily. I have, along with that, I've got two starter panels in ECR. I can do that in emergency from there as well. What is this? Guys, this is the pressure switch fitted on every, all these pumps, which are standby pumps. Remember I told you that in case if this pump stops, automatically the standby pump is going to start. It is this pressure switch which senses that the pressure has reduced, something abnormal has happened, or the pump has stopped. Automatically it gives a signal to the standby pump and it starts. That's it. And also an alarm pump. This is the NGO transfer pump, guys. And again, any pump which transfers lube oil, fuel oil, gas oil, it has to be a gear pump or a screw pump. It's a gear pump. It has got a suction filter, suction pressure, discharge pressure. Come. Okay, one more thing. What is this? Guys, this is one of the most one of the pumps which has got a pressure transmitter fitted on the discharge side. So when this pump is running, not just the pressure we see over here, we can see the pressure in engine control room on an alarm monitoring system box as well. We can see the remote display of the pressure. See how much is the discharge pressure. This is main engine generator fuel oil circulating pump. This is main engine generator fuel oil supply pump fitted on board ship. So guys, these are screw pumps. These are screw pumps provided on board for supplying fuel oil to the main engine and generator for the running. These are the purifiers. Boiler fuel oil pump, again two in number. These are the filters. In case we have to put other filter in use, we can put this lever over here, over there. This pump is running for when the boiler is firing. Pressure switch is fitted over here. A pump stop hoga, automatically another pump is going to start. This pump stops, another pump is going to start. Huge in number. Each pump, these are the butterfly valve fitted over here. Suction pressure gauge, discharge pressure gauge. This is a sewer pump. Again guys, it's a centrifugal pump. How I can say that? Because the suction is coming on the eye. It's coming on the eye. This is the centrifugal pump fitted over here. It has got suction pressure gauge and discharge pressure gauge over here. When I am talking about pumps, one of the most important pumps is main engine fuel oil pump. This is one of the units. Again guys, this is a reciprocating pump. It has got a barrel in which the plunger is moving up and down. The pressure is developed and the fuel is injected and higher pressure into the through the fuel valves into the combustion chamber. That's a fuel pump. Come. Each one of you need to really understand how this wash plate pump works. Very, very important.